to our very own Nimesh Shah as well as Anuj Singhal, who are in conversation with Samir Arora, founder and fund manager of Helios Capital. Over to you, Anuj.
Okay, Nigel, thanks a lot for that. Yes, our good friend Samir Arora is here, and as usual, he has taken time out for us, even though the conference is still going. Samir, thank you so much. You've always been a nice friend of the channel and always take time out.
Thank you.
You heard a lot of ideas. Anything that excited you today?
Well, I think they were okay. So let me not push some ideas, but I may have liked them more before I should buy them. But generally, there could have been more interesting ideas than the one which came out.
Okay, Samir, give us some ideas. You keep talking about HDFC Bank all the time.
I don't give ideas. That's why I didn't present today also.
Okay, but
I only talk big
about
picture.
I talk only about big picture.
But Samir, are you getting good ideas to buy in this market now? Given that mid-caps have rallied so hard.
You know, many people are questioning whether this rally has gone too far, too fast. So I would say that maybe in mid-caps, some mid-caps have gone up a lot. But if you look at the index, it hasn't gone anywhere for 2 years, 3 years, maybe since 15. So if I start this from November 1, then the market has not gone anywhere. But it's true that many mid-caps have gone up a lot. But that is the nature of the beast, that some people will push things beyond limit. And then they will pay their learning fee over time, and we can't overly protect anybody from that kind of momentum.
So you are away from the mid-cap and small-cap?
No, we are also there. But because we are a long-short fund, at least on the short side, some of the stocks fall a lot, like it happened if you saw last month, where some of the stocks fell 20, 30, even 45%. So that helps a little bit in these bad times, if bad times come.
Okay, we know some of your short ideas that have worked in the past, Samir. Of course, we'll not talk about them. But in general, what are the themes that you're backing right now in terms of the big thing?
So the thing is that many people look at beaten up names and say that because these stocks have not gone up, therefore today it's a buy. For example, tech, for example, pharma, for example, telecom. My theory is that if you give me an example where the stocks fall a lot and then from next day start going up, it never happens. They then consolidate for a number of quarters and then they start going up. It's not that somebody underperforms and from next day start outperforming. I don't believe that logic. So we are not in any of these three themes on the long side, and neither we want to be on the long side, and we don't look at valuation for the moment, because we have seen historically that things don't turn around. They can stabilize. They may stop falling. But they don't suddenly start going up from the next day.
Are you referring to telecom here as well? Because that was one theme.
Telecom, tech, pharma, I think there will be a long period of consolidation, if not further falling.
Okay.
But I don't, give me an example if you can, where stocks underperform and from next day start outperforming. No, I don't think it happens. Then they consolidate, then some will do well, some will do badly because the big picture tailwind is gone. So I strongly believe in momentum of fundamentals, which means when things are doing well, they continue to do well. But when they do badly, they don't turn around in a quarter or in 2 quarters. Because look at it, if a company has been outperforming for say 8-10 quarters in terms of earnings expectations of analysts and general momentum, then when the first time it disappoints, it tries very hard not to disappoint. And then it can't take it anymore, they can't handle it anymore, the expectations, and then they give up. The next quarter they say, I have had enough of that, now let me strengthen my business, let me not care about this, let me not worry about analysts. Because you have got exhausted trying to meet the expectations of the market. So I think these things take a lot of time.
Samir, we're seeing a lot of domestic liquidity off late, whether it's mutual funds, PMS, they're all seeing a lot of inflows. You talk to a lot of your international clients. Is that a sense of left-out feeling within the FIs as well?
No, there's no left-out feeling, I think. But this is a big support which they all feel good about, that they are not the only buyers. But, if you look at this year, please look at our performance 1 year also, and it's not very different from the crack. So nobody's feeling left out. If Nasdaq would be up as much as India is up. Actually, Google and Amazon.
Indian market, India has done well, right? But within the emerging market, India, MSCI.
Emerging market, India has done well, but that's because you are looking at it from December 1 or Jan 1.
Correct.
If you look at it from November 1, it won't be doing any difference from others. That's what I'm saying. Part of the reason for our market rally is because we fell 10% in November and December. So, if somebody was selling on November 1 and then coming back on Jan 1, normally it doesn't happen like that.
Samir, I'm tempted to ask this, and What do you do with a stock like Jubilant FoodWorks now, after the kind of fall that we have seen? Valuation-wise, still quite expensive. And I asked this question because you have spoken about it in the past. So how do you approach?
Keep it on the side on which it belongs.
Which is on the short side.
No, we don't know that, but things don't change. The thing is, you're discovering in front of the public a new model. Where you don't know whether the pricing of the previous guys was right, whether the way they were giving one for one was right, whether they spoiled the brand. But the reason we brilliantly got negative on the stock in the olden days was then we realized that we don't think that Indians should pay 2,000 rupees for a family to have pizza sitting at home. I mean, there has to be a limit to how the Bombay analyst community thinks that this is fair price for a product, that while sitting at home, for a family of three or four, you would spend 2,000 rupees sitting at home. I don't believe that. And so we thought always that it was, the price here was too high.
Samir, a word on GST, because finally it's most of the rates are out, it's likely to get implemented from July 1st. Is it going to be disruptive in terms of earnings, and where do you see opportunity because of the shift from unorganized to organized?
That opportunity, everybody in a big picture thinks is true, but in the short term, I think that may provide some correction only. Although I believe that at the end of the day, people will say that this is part of the sort of game of moving to a new system, that these things happen. But then people also get disappointed. So this may be an excuse one day, whenever we need an excuse to correct.
This is going to be a big game changer?
No, I don't think anything in life is a big changer, because nothing is a big changer from day one, because I have bought a cable company in 2002, thinking that we are about to get conditional access. Until today, nobody makes money. And then we saw Telecom in 90s. Until 2004, Bharti was below par. And then we've seen in any sector that the first day of things versus when somebody really makes money on that factor or on that event is 5 years down. But it's a good general backdrop, positive direction. But nothing is going to change that suddenly from 1st of July everybody start paying their taxes. I don't believe that.
You know, for longest your biggest long idea has been HDFC Bank, Samir.
And
all the private sector banks. Does that include ICICI Bank now?
Because nowadays, yes.
Okay, and do you get a sense that the worst is over and can it now catch up?
We consider ICICI Bank as the best among the PSU banks. when I bought it, which was about 4-6 weeks ago,
yes.
All the PSU banks were up 30-60%, all the private sector banks were up 30%, and ICICI was up 10% or something, now it's up 25%.
Yes.
So we said it has to be one of those. So it's okay if you want to be a little bit aggressive in terms of thinking that the corporate loans will improve one day and then the NPS will improve one day. It's sort of better than the other
side. Is it a core portfolio bet for you now or trading bet for now?
It's a futures bet.
Okay.
But it has some benefits, that it has subsidiaries which are valuable, and those subsidiaries many of the PSUs don't have, and many of the pure private guys don't have because they are in other, like HDFC has them and not HDFC Bank. So there's some value. But in the first round, it was too much to go from not ever owning it or not owning it for a long time to suddenly saying it's our core. But it can become
okay.
The next round of money.
Samir, 3 years of Modi government, they've delivered on some of the promises that they had spoken when they came to power. As an investor sitting outside of India, how satisfied with the performances so far, and do you think the reform process is likely to continue?
I think main thing is that the whole world now knows what Mr. Modi is doing, so that is a very big positive for an India fund manager, because now they know a few things.
Correct.
Like demonetization, everybody knows. Financial inclusion, a little bit they know. A little bit of Aadhaar type, if not the word.
Correct.
But broadly they know, because Mr. Modi has been a good marketeer of India and has definitely raised profile. No doubt. When I do, because I have to do conference calls with these investors once every month with a few, different calls. And mostly because of the coverage that Mr. Modi gets in Financial Times and whatever, Wall Street maybe, I don't know, but Financial Times definitely more. They know quite a bit. So it's not like, so that I think is a big help. And these things are big picture, which everybody likes. Now, sometimes I feel we have not done enough because it's slow, it's taken time, but sort of the world likes it a lot, and it has definitely been a big hit.
Samir, your thoughts on story of the day today, which is the market backing the organized players. Titan, for example, is up 15% today. A lot of these stocks have surged, you know, names like Bata and all. Is this a story which is getting ahead of itself?
We also like many of these teams where there's organized to unorganized. But my thinking is that if you today start believing that the unorganized will go out of business, maybe he'll make less money, but he's not going to go out of business. But if you believe that the unorganized is much bigger than organized, if you start believing that the unorganized guys will lose business, lose jobs, and there are even no organized jobs, so how will our country work? So you have to believe the other side, that they will find a way. Maybe they'll make less money, maybe they'll have to pay more taxes, but they shall not disappear from the face of this earth so easily, as they have not disappeared from so many other things that have been thrown at them. That's the thing. I don't think it'll all happen in one round, but maybe the delta is there for sure in the favor of the organized.
Samir, a word on the taxation front. You know, every now and then we keep hearing about some issues with P-notes or something to do with, you know, the taxation in India. Do you think most of the taxation worries are behind us as far as the FI investors are concerned?
No, I don't think they are behind, but now people have moved on. But the actual issues never go away from our country. For example, now they say that P-note should not be used for speculation. But what is investing if not speculation which has worked? So we don't know from where they come up with these things, but it's okay. As long as the market is going up, everything is allowed in this world.
Okay, Samir, last time you were here, told us that you recently invested in BSE, and very simple logic that, you know, the NSE IPO will come, so I don't know, now you know this is just
but now we have the other IPO coming.
Yes, exactly. So any other such story that
I'm not telling you that one came out of my mouth by mistake.
but you're staying put with BSE.
Okay, nowadays you are forced to look at them everything with a 1-year angle, because